All right, I was just explaining. It's recording?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, I see. Good. We need to test this sometime during the week and figure out how we can do that if you cannot make it on, you know, sometime.
Mondays I'm always on, but Tuesdays okay. Not always.
All right. Okay, guys. If you can all mute yourselves, that would be great. It's just always a little bit easier, and you can just unmute yourselves when you are on the call. I mean, when we talk to you, or you want to ask something. So,
how do we mute ourselves?
In the lower left hand corner of your screen, under audio, actually next to audio, there's a microphone. You just click.
Okay, I see it.
Okay. Alrighty. Okay, guys. Well, we are starting a little bit late, but we'll just go a little faster tonight since this is the second round for most of you. Thanks for everybody being on the call tonight. It's a pleasure, an honor, and a privilege for me, Stuart, and Aaron to lead the call for, and lead these level 2 and 3 calls for you guys. And I love it how a lot of you are stepping up and telling me that you don't want to be full of chicken shit, but you want to fly like eagles, soar like eagles. So those who haven't seen that video, I guess you'll have to watch it to know what I'm talking about, right? But I love it how you guys are stepping up. See you, man. So the first thing that I want to do is I just want to stress the importance of the clean eat inviting. I've been getting quite a few people, and I've been following Stuart's system. So for my team, you know, it is in our Google documents under the TTTM clean eating group. And what I've been doing, what Stuart's does is we have them give their phone number. I text them. If they respond, I get them over to friend us on Facebook. And then on Facebook, I ask them to create the account. Stuart and I feel pretty strongly that you should not create the account for the people, because it's free, right? And it's a free account. The group is free. So how serious are they if they are not going to create the account? I think that's a good filter to use right away, to do it that way. But if you were sending out just an email or at an autoresponder, which is great if you have it, I've looked at the open rates and people who've seen it, and it's amazing to me that a lot of people don't check their emails anymore, you know, or it goes to their spam folder and don't look for it. So that's why I like Stuart's system of first getting the mobile number, texting them, and then getting them over to Facebook. There's your friend for your power of three. Then you send them a message, ask them how they are. There's your first message. And then you get into ask them, that's basically your invite when you ask them to create their own free Team Beachbody account. Now, we can always tweak our ads and our posts. And for those of you who are new, it's got a warm market. You guys should have a lot of people in there. You should just get on and start inviting all your friends and ask them to join the clean eating group. It's first connect a little bit, you know, the forming process, and then invite. And it's such a low impact way of inviting, you know, it's not hard selling. You are offering a service, it's for free. And so it's really easy to start that way. As I said to Alfredo before, hey, if you've got people that's ready to get a challenge pack or that want to sign up as a coach, by all means, use the scripts and work them through with that. Work through that with them. And but what Stuart has been and other people on his team has been able to do very, very successfully is getting a lot of people into the clean eat group, which naturally has a few, 10 or 20% of them, buying challenge packs. So there's your success club for the month, and there's also your and coaches coming out of it. So it's a very inobtrusive is the word I was looking for, way of doing it. And so for these next 2 weeks, we have 2 weeks left in this month, because we start our groups always on the first Monday of the month, which the next one will be May the 4th, is to last 2 weeks of the month now really, really focus and hammer on the clean eating group. If you don't have Success Club 5 yet, obviously you're going to have to mix it up a little bit and try to get people into challenge packs, but right now you should be following up aggressively and converting people that was in your previous clean eating group. But it's okay to also invite for coach mentorship or challenge group, but your focus should be on the clean eating group, because once you get that thing going, it will start rolling and start snowballing, and you will you will not even have to chase down Success Club points anymore. And it's not all about Success Club. You know, Success Club is very important to accomplish in our business, but the focus shouldn't be, I got 3 points, I need one more, I need two more, whatever. It should be, how many more people can I help this month? That's what your outlook should be. And if that's the outlook, then you would have no problem helping people with that. Stuart has posted this in the group, some messages about daily accountability. Most of you that are on this call has been doing a great job of posting your power of threes and also posting your other accountability. For those that are not, haven't done it, I believe I put the link up for the GoPro audiobook, and it's on YouTube and it's free. So if you haven't listened to it, I recommend listening to 20 minutes every day. Unless you, of course, you are doing RPM with us right now, then that should be your main focus. Because as I've posted in the RPM group, you really got to listen to the same recording a few times, because there's just so much stuff that Tony gives you, which that's a little bit beside the point. But there are some RPM people on here. That's why I'm mentioning it. So what I want to know from you guys tonight is, what personal development are you guys doing? I mentioned the GoPro audiobook if you haven't done it, but if you've done it already, unmute yourselves, please, and let us know what you are doing right now for personal development, and how many minutes per day, and when you do it, on the car or in the morning first thing or whatever. Jennifer, Jessica, I think you're unmuted.
Okay, I am currently reading GoPro, and I'm also listening to the Shalene Show podcast.
Okay, great.
And I'm working on PD about an hour a day.
Okay, so you're reading and you're listening is about an hour.
Correct. Yeah. I listen to Shalene in the morning when I first get to work, and I read GoPro at night before I go to bed.
Cool. Cool. You will reap the benefits from that. You know, we say to people, do at least 10 minutes to start with, preferably a half an hour, but if you could get an hour of personal development in, that's really what it takes. And I see Erin nodding her head. Alfredo, what are you doing?
I was currently doing The Magic of Thinking Big, the audio.
Right.
First thing in the morning, 30, 45 minutes as I'm getting ready for the day, drinking my coffee. And today I switched over to RPM, listening to Tony Robbins, which I'm pretty excited about.
Yep. Awesome. Awesome. And how far are you into Magic of Thinking Big?
I think I'm about 2 hours in. So I think I've only got about another hour left or so.
Okay.
Some book. Yeah.
It's a really good book. If anybody hasn't haven't read that or listened to it, it's definitely an outstanding book. It really, really helps you to change your focus and to build your belief.
What was the name of it again?
The Magic of Thinking Big.
Thank you.
Alfredo, you know who the author is? I can't think off the top of my head.
I don't remember. It's on the top of my head. I'll look it up in a second.
David Schwartz.
David Schwartz. That's right.
Yeah. All right. 561 phone number, area code.
I'm sorry, Johan. This is Maria, waiter from Florida.
Hi, Maria.
Hi, how are you guys doing?
Good. Good to hear you.
I just joined the meeting, so and I just heard what the last... So are you asking what are we doing for personal development right now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I started listening to the Eat the Frog.
Okay.
Eat that frog.
Good. Good. We just were talking about that. That is something that you were struggling with a little bit. So that would really help a lot.
Yes, yes. Definitely had help already. I mean, I haven't done the, yeah, but I'm not doing Beachbody 10 hours a day. I'm doing it in less hours now.
Right, right.
Yeah.
No, that's good.
That'd be a great help. Yeah.
Thank you, Maria. 41.
Thank you.
417.
Yes, that's Michelle.
Hey, Michelle.
Hello.
Yes.
Right now, mm-hmm. Let's see, right now I'm reading Spirit Driven Success by Danny Johnson, and I'm starting this week on the RPM.
Okay, great. That is RPM is obviously great, but that book from Danny is one of the best books that I've ever read. Period, nonstop. Love it. Absolutely love it. Let's see. Jessica is here. Maybelle, you want to chip in here?
Sorry, I had trouble unmuting. So right now I'm listening to an audiobook. You Are a Badass.
Oh, right. You already like that.
Yeah, it's great.
I see Brooke Dorsett speaks very highly of it and actually gives it to all our new coaches, or no, those that make Emerald, actually.
It's a really great book for getting that sense of empowerment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So. Excellent. I'm glad there's somebody here that that is doing that because I've been wanting to get that next and do that.
Yeah. And actually, I wish I had bought the book as opposed to the audio. I think because there's a lot of things that she says in there that I'd like to bookmark and highlight, and I can't
write and go back to
audio. Yeah, so I think I might go back and just skip the paperback.
Cool. Thank you for sharing. Deanna, what are you doing for PD?
Well, currently I do get daily emails from a Think and Grow Rich group that I joined. I haven't been able to get on the GoPro audio because for some reason the link, when I click it and go to YouTube, it tells me that it's been pulled, I think, for copyright or something. So I don't know if I can get an updated link that you have.
I'll look for it while you're talking.
Okay. And I haven't started the RPM yet because I wasn't sure. I hadn't heard anything in the email where we were getting started.
Oh, we have a group, and I added you to the RPM group.
Okay, then I just need to.
And you guys can start because I was, as you guys go along in the RPM group, which you guys can post what your takeaways are and what are you learning. And for us to be accountable to each other and be doing it, I just feel that we should at least by Sunday post what we've done for the week and where we are so that we can always kind of be on the same page. It's kind of nice to know there's a bunch of other people doing the same as you are.
Okay, yes.
Who is Mrs. Clark? How are you? Christine? Hi, Christine. You were muted.
Hi.
There you go.
Are you asking what I'm reading?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I am currently reading The Slight Edge.
Okay, still okay.
Yeah, it's still going. Yeah, I do what I can.
What's standing out to you so far, except that you got to take daily consistent action and the small things add to a lot?
I mean, it's pretty much an expanded version of the compound effect. So it's good, though. It's good reminders.
Mm-hmm. Good. All right, Mr. Cliff Jones.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? So I, oddly enough, it's funny how God works. I met a guy earlier this week. He bought my car, and cool. We were standing around in my garage, and I noticed just how, you know, hideous it is with all the junk in there, and we're getting ready for a new baby and all that. So anyway, long story short, I was just talking to him how I really would like to pare down and live more of a minimalistic lifestyle. That really is intriguing to me. And so he recommended a book called Essentialism by a guy named Greg McCown.
Mm-hmm.
And, so I downloaded that today, started listening to it. And I think it's a great PD book in a lot of ways, because it talks about how you can really just whittle down things and get to freeing yourself up to being able to make the highest contribution in whatever it is that you're doing. So I think that certainly is of value to this business, because we can really get bogged down in chasing people down and trying to, you know, because we get, especially in the beginning. I mean, I'm only in my seventh month, and sometimes, you know, you feel desperate to really land a client or convince somebody to buy a challenge pack, and you just get really bogged down in things, majoring in the minors, so to speak. So I'm really excited about what this book is going to teach me in terms of developing a process and streamlining things.
Okay, great, Cliff. Thank you for sharing that. Who are we? Did we not talk to yet? Did we cover everybody? If we haven't covered everybody, please go ahead and unmute yourselves. Okay, yes. That video has also been blocked, Diana. We might have to find a different one. Actually, you guys can download the audio if you want to. From the video audio from my Google Docs. If I'll post it in the group later, if you guys want to do that. I just need to figure out where I, oh, okay, I know where I got it. This should allow you guys to, and I'll post this in level 2. I'll create a document for it and then and put it in there so you guys can, if you want to listen to it, you can do that. It's on YouTube. Pro audio book. Let me know if you have any issues with it. You're basically downloading it from my Google Drive to your Google Drive, and then you would have to upload it to your phone or whatever you want to listen it on. So, okay, guys. So, just getting back to our agenda. All right. Well, again, as we have said before, if you are here and if you're here, you are obviously serious and you want to improve. And so if you have not signed up for Summit, I think there's still a few tickets left. Absolutely get to Summit. There is just I wouldn't say no excuse, but it's just really not negotiable. It would be like if you work for any company or organization and they have their big event of the year, whatever it is, you are expected to go there. Now with Beachbody, it's optional, but I can promise you, and you can ask Aaron and Maybell, who I know has been there, that you come back, even if you've gone the second, third or fourth time, you come back just so fired up and you learn so much and you meet so many new people. It's just a must to be there. Just like you need to be at Super Saturday this Saturday. And then something that I feel very strongly about also is that you really need to try and get onto the Success Club. I don't even know if you can still register, but you can get on the waiting list at least. And the more Success Club points you have, the more you can get. We'd like to see you guys all on the cruise next year. Now talk about being fired up. You get very fired up because of that too. It is much more relaxing than Summit. And the nice thing is you get to hang out on the cruise with a lot of of the really top coaches, because at Summit there's so many people. On the cruise, there's only an X amount of people. So you really get to hang out with the top coaches and pick their brains and see how they think and what they do and learn from them. With that, I want to throw a third event in there, which is not on at all on the agenda. And that is the Network Marketing Pro event, October 11th to 14th in Vegas. Now, it's all sold out, but there are a few tickets that's been available of people who can go. And that would be like, if you are a fireman, that would be like the National Firemen's Association event, you know. And it is just unreal, 3.5 days of nonstop personal development. Incredible. This year, Tony Robbins himself is going to be there for an evening. Just that should be enough right there, you know. So start thinking about it. I have two tickets available for my team. And I think there's two people on our team who can go at this point that or said they can go that we might have tickets available for. It's only $200 for the ticket.
I also am going to have my ticket available. I think someone's going to buy it. But obviously that week I will probably be having my C-section. So obviously right. I can't go. I think someone's buying mine. But if not, I'll post it in the group.
Yeah, post it in the Empire Goes Pro groups.
I think so. I have someone buying it. But if not, no.
So if you are not going to GoPro, it's October, it's in Vegas, it's at the Mirage Hotel, start thinking about it. After Summit, we are definitely going to make sure that you guys need to know that you need to go to that and plan for that. It is, you cannot just go to no events during the year. You know, it would be like living on an island. You can't build this business that way. And here's the thing, Super Saturday, Summit, Success Club Trip, and GoPro, those are great events to get to know other people on your team, but also to find a success partner. And I can tell you right now that if it wasn't for Stuart, for sure, has been my success partner for a long time, I would have quit last year about this time, for sure. Because I was just not going anywhere, and now I went to Star Diamond. So the importance of success partners is just really, really important. Stuart and I even have a success group with some other coaches where we're like 8 people in there and share together. That is really something that you guys need to really, really focus on, is to find a success partner. And I do not recommend finding a success partner in your own team, in which I mean team gets super fit or team to the max. Go across team, somebody in the empire. And since we are connected here with two teams, well, Aaron, you actually have your own team too, right? So yeah. That's a different name. So technically 3 teams. You guys need to maybe talk back and forth across and see if you can find a success partner. Stuart and I talk every week at 4 p.m. Central Time for 45 minutes to an hour. And we've come up with a lot of things. And it's obviously obvious to you guys what our cooperation level is like and our friendship, you know. But it's just been really good. I mean, there is just no secrets between me and him. We share absolutely everything. We even have our own little group, just me and him in the group. So if we have important stuff, we post it in there so we don't have to scroll through 10,000 messages to see where is that thing that he posted about, you know. So make that something very important on your agenda to start looking this Super Saturday for a success partner. We want to focus on the Clean Eat group until the 3 days or so before we start, and that's the same for all the teams. And then, you know, in that first week or 2 weeks, you can go right back into inviting to the Clean Eat group. But I like inviting to the coaching sneak peek or to your mentorship or to a challenge group, so that you're not inviting all month long for the cleaning group, but only the last 2 weeks. Otherwise, people get used to the same message, I think. So it's good to take a break in between. Now, has anybody made Emerald in here since our last call or since this group started?
No.
If you have, just unmute yourselves. Who is at Success Club 5?
Becky's not on this call, but she made Emerald.
Oh, very cool. Becky, on behalf of all of us, congratulations. That's awesome. I hope you can get close to, well, not close to you, can get your Success Club 5 so you can join us on Level 3 next month. I don't have Success Club 5 either yet. So
me neither, too.
Yep, me too. But we want to party a little bit. Well. Yeah.
But it'll be 5 by the end of
Yeah, but I know I'm going to enroll at 2 coaches this week. So.
Yeah, I have one this week too, so.
Pretty sure about that. You know, if you're going to run your own group, you need to take ownership for it. And the clean eating groups, it's nice to do it as a team together. But I have one coach that stepped off and are doing her own group with her people. And it's all good, you know, whatever works. But in the beginning, it's probably better for the newbies to jump in with the team groups and so that they can learn how to run it. For the 21-day fixed group, and maybe Aaron knows about this, but we all have been using Hootsuite to schedule to the groups, as Stuart has been scheduling to these groups. But as of the end of this month, no more scheduling to groups. But I hear that Buffer will still allow you to schedule to groups. I don't know if that is true. Alfredo, you are doing it right now. You're just posting manually. So that's okay to, you know, totally okay to do that. But if you could sit down and schedule all your posts, that'd be great. We just don't know for sure what service is going to allow that.
I'm starting now doing it manually just to be used to it because everything is scheduled.
Have you tried Buffer? Because from what I've read is that they will still be allowed to schedule. But I think that eventually Facebook will clamp down on that. They just don't want that, you know. But anyway, it's important that when you're running a challenge group, and here's another very important thing, is that even if you have a team leader, volunteer to take the challenge group over from him so you can do the daily posts. And follow up. We've had a great thing going in our team where Christine led it. Really, really kick ass 21-day fix and 21-day fix extreme group. And Kristen is leading it and doing an excellent job with it. And that's how you build leadership and you build skills, by taking over things like that. So volunteer for that. Such as in our Body Beast group where Alfredo volunteer to post and basically leading the group to an extent, which is awesome. Thank you very much. All right, so creating your Facebook page. That there is a video in your homework or in the post for the week about that. I think it's today's post, actually, or maybe it was yesterday's post. How to do that with a video from Rochelle Griffin and how to do that. You could also, I wanted to point out for the new people on the call that's not been here before, that absolutely do what Rochelle says. She's a pro and she knows exactly, and she's not just done all the trainings with Sandy Krakowski that you can imagine, but she was a coach for Sandy. But if you also want to see a little bit what I've done, because I was also with Sandy, it is important that on your like page is that there is a reference to your website and to your either transformation video or your coaching story. So on my like page, when people go there, that's what they see under my about. That's the first things they see. Because I want to build a relationship with them, and the best way to build a relationship is to have them watch my transformation video. Not my coaching story video, but my transformation video. And then in the about section, you will see that there is just like a whole bunch of info, subcategories, and now I've got the description in there, mission, the bio, all that stuff. You can basically copy what I have in there, just tweak it to your own interest in your own things, you know. But you want to look really professional with it. And I'm sure Rochelle talks about that in the video as well. Then what I also want to point out to you is on your personal page, it is crucial that in the very first thing on the left-hand side of About You section, is that you have the link to your like page on your personal page. So you need to make sure that you have this. That's my like page name. So when I hover over it, it brings up the like page. You need to make sure that you have that link bold in there. That is the, and you want to set it up so that that's the first thing that comes up that people will see, so they can click on it and find you on your like page. As far as the like page goes, we recommend scheduling 5 to 6 times per day, but eventually work your way up to 10 to 12 times per day. And there's no problem with scheduling to your like page with Hootsuite Buffer, Postcron, or Sprout Social, which I absolutely love.
I use Sprout Social too.
Yeah, it's freaking awesome. So I wish they would let you post to groups, but since Facebook's new policy, that's not going to be big deal anymore, you know. So, and you want to sit down, and I will just be honest, you know, I have an assistant in the Philippines who worked for me, and I've trained her. I spent hours and hours with her on Zoom and training her and messaging back and forth. And I gave her a list of resources to find, and she built her own list. And she does a lot of the posts for me, but she leaves some slots open for me for my daily video, and for my story about, I make sure that I post twice a week now about Beachbody coaching, a soft post as we call it. Typically on Mondays, I post about what it has done for me and my family. On Thursday, I post something financially because it's payday on Thursday. And if you guys are not doing that, write that down. That is your main thing to do, is post every week, at least twice on a Monday and a Thursday, if you want a guide about a soft post about coaching. Just talk about it. That way, when you do have an ad running or you make a post about wanting to get people in your mentorship, people has already started building a little bit of belief, and they've seen that, because people need to see things 5 to 6 times before they buy into it. I can tell you that since I started working with Barbie, the two things that has been crucial for me in the last year working with Barbie that she always points out is make a post about coaching, and it works. And, you know, Erin works with Barbie too, so she can tell you the same. And the other thing is, as we are critiquing like pages in level 3, that's why you should get to level 3 so we can really work with you guys there, is we want to see you. Sometimes we don't post enough of ourselves. I'm very guilty of it too. Somebody does an excellent job of it is Maybell, if you want to check her out, her page. So, because I just reviewed it last week, and she posted a lot, which is awesome. We've been, you know, even if I didn't know you, you know, after watching your stuff on your page, I feel like I know you, you know.
Oh, thanks.
So that's the connection that you guys want to build, you know, is with your people, is your YouTube videos, the videos that you do. The videos is crucial on your page. We require in our level 3 group that people do one video per week. But while you are here in level 2, start making a habit of posting regular videos. I try to do 5 a week. But even if you can start by just doing one, and I promise you the first 1 or 2 or 10 is not going to be great, because you're going to be nervous and you're not going to feel good. But later on, it's just like, now I just turn it on, turn the light on. It's like, talk, 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 blah, 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 signing off. See you later. Bye.
Now, funny because I looked at a video that I had made in 2010 and I was like, that was horrible. Why did I post that on YouTube?
Right.
But they were horrible. So I've improved a lot since 2010.
So freaking nervous. You feel sorry for yourself, you know, when you do that. But that's how we grow and learn, you know. So very important, guys, to do that. And then I was going to, on the Facebook page, I've just point out to you guys, you want to go to your insights on a weekly basis and look and see what your likes are. Will your post is reaching, but most important is when most of your people are online and what time of the day they are online. So if you're only going to post 3, 4, 5 times a day, obviously from 10 in the evening, my time zone, to anytime basically from 3-4 in the afternoon are peak times to post. So you want to look at that so you can, I post my soft posts about coaching and my post about a challenge group and stuff like that in this peak time zone always. Just one, not a lot, just one, and the other post is very useful post. And then you want to look at the people, and you will find out very quickly what your target is. And even if you are not targeting that, this is your target because these are the people coming to your page. So you definitely want to always take a look at that. So now my ads are geared to this age group. All my ads are just for this age group because that's by far the most. And I use woman only on Facebook. Also, when you with your post, going back to that, is you can see here what post had the most engagement on your like page. And when you start seeing one that has more engagement, and that's not an ad, that was just, you can see that was a video though. Just look at that here's a prime example. Look at the this is the reach and engagement, these little bars, and the wider it is, the more it is. Look at that for the video that I posted. And it was just something silly, you know, that I posted this morning. So you will get to learn from when you're doing this, what type of things does your customers really like. That is just a regular post, but people always obviously like that. So, you know, you want to recycle these posts. My assistant and I actually bookmark these posts that do really well. She uses Sprout Social. And we write down the links for it, and so that then, so, and then 3 months later, we go and reschedule some of the same posts again, which is a great way, so you don't have to come up with content. You know what works. 3 months in a row, there's so much noise on social media and so much traffic that they will know that they've seen it, but they probably won't know that they've seen it from you. If they, and maybe they haven't seen it. So it's definitely not a bad thing to do that. If I keep scrolling down, I'll find another video and I'll show you the, but there's another video that was Friday. Friday is a bad day in social media, and you can see the engagement here is quite significant. So you will see what your people like. It's motivational and a lot of motivational, inspirational stuff. Aaron, I'm going to ask you to talk about this motivation interest list a little bit, if you don't mind, because I'm not
even sure what that is.
Me neither. maybe I'll do, you know?
I'm not quite sure, Johan, to be quite honest with you.
What I think.
Motivation, interest list?
Mm-hmm. What I believe it is that if you go on your like page and you would see who's liking you on your like page, liking your posts, is would be to see what this person likes. So this might take some time to do now. Obviously, I'm in my like page. I gotta go over to my personal page to put that link in there to see about her. And so you can see, I think it's in the about section. No, it's on the left here. Places, sports. You can see what kind of things they like. You should also see a little bit about, this is probably not a good example. Normally, it shows pages that people like. Let's just put Aaron's name in here. By the way, Miss Aaron, I don't see your like page link on top of your personal page.
I don't know how to make that the top.
You just have to play with it in the about section.
It's down, four down.
Yeah, right. You want to have that right on top, you know.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to fix that.
That needs to be right on top. So that's something that I've learned from Sandy big time. Well, I can just tell by your photos what you like, you know. and I mean, here's the thing that I was talking about, interest list. I can see that she's very involved in the fitness, like woman in fitness. Jamie Eason is awesome, by the way. And the music that she likes and the kind of movies. So
if you see, we have a kid.
Right. But the way I understand this is that you will start seeing after a while who is commenting most on your posts, on mm-hmm. your like page, and who is liking most of your posts. And I think those are the people that you also want to go look at their profiles and see what they like, so you can get a better idea how to specifically target your audience. And we talk about having an avatar. There's something like that. If I know the link or somebody knows the link, they can post in the group, where you design your own avatar. That's your ideal client. And for that, you would post as if you're posting specifically just to that person. Anybody want to chip in, please do on that.
Has everyone here created an avatar before? I created one a while ago and I posted it on my like page.
I never have, actually.
Yeah. I'm happy to share it if anybody's interested.
Oh, please do. Please share it with us.
Let me see if I can find it.
Okay. We have pretty much covered everything. Very important to listen to Sandy Krakowski's Facebook number one call this week. I just want to point out to my team, or team to the max, to pay attention to where the heck is that thing that I put in here?
The homework.
Okay, right here, yeah. These. Some of these things, just to pay attention with that, do some extra homework that I've given you guys with the GoPro audio and stuff like that. So going back to, now I lost my place. Oh, actually, not that one, Diana. This one. This is the one I was looking for. Team to the max, additional homework to 1, 2, 3, and to do before and during level 2. So just go there and follow that, guys, please.
Yes, I think I did click that because you give us what to do before the level 2 and then what to do right after the level 2.
Right. I just wrote this new today, so this would be... this would be very specific, you know. Yes. And this document you can look at too. Okay, sorry to apologize to the other teams, but since we don't have a team call, I just need to get logistics in here, which, by the way, we will have a team call, not next week, but the following week, which is the off week. And we can touch on anything that you guys want to touch on, whatever you want us to train on. I think we've covered everything on the agenda so far. Any questions, guys? I'll open it up for questions.
Johan, I just sent you that avatar via message.
Okay, cool. And share with the others?
Okay, you can share with it. I don't know how to share my screen, so I sent it to you via message.
Okay, let me do that quickly. Okay, guys, there's my bells. That's good. This is not in your official homework, but I really recommend you guys do this, because that really helps you to connect with your target market. And you can tell on your Facebook page who you are connecting to, but you can also pick your market. That's great. You know, where she comes from, what she's all about, does she have a job, what does she like for working out, what's her favorite sports. This is great. I can post that in a document in our team page, Maybelle, if that's okay with you.
Yeah, that's fine, man. I'm perfectly fine with that.
I don't think I can do that while Zoom is on, so maybe I can. No, it won't let me do that. So we can do that. Any other questions you guys have? Where we are? Who is ready for level 3? Got 2 weeks left. Who is going to Super Saturday this weekend?
I'm so sad I'm going to miss it.
Ours is actually Super Sunday.
Okay.
Is it Sunday, Jessica?
Yeah, it's Sunday.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm still going to miss it. I'll be out of town.
Where do we go to keep up with the Super Saturday schedule?
It's in the back office, under event and news and training and then events. Okay. The one that we are going to Chicago is in Schaumburg. Okay. Any other questions, guys? Very good. Well, my brother Stuart is going to lead the level 3 call tomorrow night. So I wish you guys a great week. I want to reiterate, well, I actually haven't said it, so I'm going to say it and reiterate it at the same time. Please post your conversations for us. You will learn so much from posting either off your text on your phone or your Facebook messages. Post your conversations you have with people. Ask for advice. Somebody did that at level 3 today, and it was really good. That way, not just you learn, but everybody else in the group learns. And, you know, we just have more experience than you guys. You know, we've done more personal development. Not that we're that good, but we just been around the block a couple of times. So we kind of know what works and what doesn't work. So between me and Maybelle and Aaron, Stuart, and Christine, we can definitely help you guys out if you would post. The more you would put into it and give to us, the more we can give back to you. Right. As far as that goes. Have a great Super Saturday. Have a great week, everybody. Have a great night, too.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Good night. Thank you. Good night, all.
Aaron, you'll post a recording, right?